I've finally received my little wheel balancer, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to get this set up, and then we'll get the wheels on and we'll balance the front and back wheels for the ZX10R 2006 model. So in the box, this was a cheap wheel balancer. It was about £30 online on eBay, and I thought, you know, there's ones that are way more expensive, but what's the point in buying something ridiculously expensive when all I want to just do is balance a couple of wheels? So this is what you get. There's the base, there's the main stand bits, there's the actual wheel balancing thing that will stand on top of these, and then some fitments. Annoyingly, I actually got some weights from my work, but it comes with a bunch of weights already, which is quite handy. So they could have just been used themselves, but maybe I would have needed more. Anyway, I'm going to get this built, and then we'll get the wheel through and we can test it. There's the actual pictures. I can pretty much build it from that, which is simple enough. Like those little feet bits there, I wasn't sure where they went, but they just go on the actual base, so that's easy enough. And it seems like there's two settings, like there's one there, so I presume it's for different sizes of wheels, but I think my wheels should be fine if I put it in the end. If not, I can always put it in the middle one, so that's fine. That basically will just rest on there. So you'll have your wheel in the middle, and that allows you to just spin it on these little bearings. So let's get this tightened up, the four bolts, and we'll get the wheel on. This goes through your wheel, and these are the bits that basically lock into your axle area, so it holds it in place. So now I've got that through fairly level. I'm going to put it on the wheel balancer, and then we're going to just have a wee spin and see what it's like. So let's get this on here. So that's that, and let's give it a wee spin. I'm just going to do it 90 degrees at a time, so we'll just see where it kind of stops. Right, so that's kind of settling, so let's get our weight on here. I said I probably need 25, but I actually took 30. Yeah, it's quite hard to actually get it perfect. So, you know, I think 30 is maybe just a tiny little bit over, but 25 is too little. So, without cutting them in half, which I'm not going to do, I could have just put 3 tens there instead. But that seems to have got it now. So, it's like if I move it, it's like I said, it's a wee slight bit going towards that way, as you can see, but it seems to stabilize. If I put it to the other side, it seems to stabilize there. So, right, so this one was actually a lot easier to balance. It only took 15. So yeah, it's like stopping. We put the weights to there. See, it's not moving anywhere. Put it to there. It's kind of just staying pretty stable. So I think that back wheel is actually almost perfect, which is great. So yeah, I've managed to just move the weights over there, more in the centre a bit instead. And I checked in, it seemed to work fine, so it's all balanced. I think this wheel balancer, for the sake of £32, I think it was, or £27 or something, for the sake of £27, you know, you could have taken this to a shop and they would have charged you anything from £5 to £10, maybe about £6, £7 for each wheel. So you know, a couple of times taking your wheels and changing your tires or whatever, you know, you've paid your money back. That's that, guys. Obviously, I'm a qualified mechanic, so do this at your own, so you can risk. If you feel more comfortable taking it to a shop, then do it in a shop, I'd say. But I'm trying to learn more stuff as I go along, try to do more bits and bobs like fitting the bearings and, you know, changing brake pads and stuff like that. Simple stuff that you end up spending 3 times as much just on labour than you are for the parts. So I'd rather just do these things myself. And I think it's good to understand some basics of motorbike maintenance anyway, which makes life a little bit easier. Anyway, that's that for this video. I'll catch you later, guys. Take care.